Now that we know how to add and subtract mixed numbers, let's try some multiplication. Now back when we were adding and subtracting, we took our mixed numbers, broke them into an integer part and a fractional part. You know what we do when we find something that works? We keep on doing it. So that's what we're going to try here. We're going to take our 8.5, we're going to write that as 8 plus 1/2. Now we can just use the distributive property. Break this up into 6 times 8 plus 6 times 1/2. 6 times 8, that's just 48. And 6 times 1/2, well, that's 6 divided by 2, that's just 3. And that gives us 51. That kind of makes sense, right? 6 times 8 would be 48. 6 times 9 is 54. 6 times 8.5, we expect it to be right between 48 and 54. That's 51. Now, let's try multiplying two mixed numbers. Now, once again, we have a strategy that works. We're going to go ahead and break this up into integer part and fractional parts. So we have 4 plus 2/3 times 4 plus 1/5. Oh. Yuck. And we do the distributive property. We'll have to multiply this whole thing by 4 and then this whole thing by 1/5. We'll have to do the distributive property a couple more times. Ah, that's just annoying. Maybe there's got to be a better way to do this. Wait, we know how to multiply fractions. If we can just take these and turn them into fractions, then we'll be all set. 4 plus 2/3, well, 4 is just 12/3. So we're adding on the 2/3. 12 plus 2, that's 14/3. Oh, we don't even really have to write this out. We can see this right from the beginning. 4 and 2/3, well, 4 is 12/3. Add on the 2/3, we get 14/3. We can do the same thing over here with the 4 and 1/5. 4 is just 20/5. We add on the 1, and we'll get 21/5. I usually skip this step in the middle. I just think it up here in my head. Now, we can multiply fractions. We know how to do this. We can do a little cancellation first. We see the 21 and the 3 have a common factor of 3. Do a little canceling there. So now we have 14 times 7 over 1 times 5. 14 times 7. Well, 14 is 2 times 7. So we go 7 times 7 is 49. Double that, we get a 98. And on the bottom, we have 1 times 5. That gives us 5. Now, the problem's in mixed numbers. So we're going to write our final answer in terms of a mixed number, too. 5 goes into 98. Well, 5 times 19 is 95. So this is 19. And then we have, from 95, we go up 3 more to get to 98. So this is 19 3/5. Now, at the end of these types of problems, I usually like to do a little sanity check and make sure our answer kind of makes sense. Up here, we look at 4 2/3 times 4 1/5. That's going to be more than 4 times 4, which is 16. Sure enough, that's more than 16. And this is going to be less than 5 times 5, which is 25. Sure enough, that's less than 25. This quick check helps us avoid huge mistakes. You know, if we'd come out to an answer of like 12 3/5, we'd know immediately we were wrong, because 12 3/5 is less than 4 times 4. So sanity checking is a good thing. Now let's move on to, word problem. Oh, yeah, I have this secret cookie recipes. Cookies are awesome, but I need a whole lot of flour here. 5 1/3 cups, and I got this really weird scoop that holds 2/3 of a cup. Now, how many scoops do I need to get all the way up to 5 1/3 cup? Now, I could just count it out, go 2/3, 4/3, 6/3, and try to figure out when I'm going to hit the 5 1/3, but, you know, could I just multiply or divide these numbers some way? Which is it multiplication? Is it division? Fractions confuse me sometimes. One way I deal with that is I turn the problem into something that doesn't have any fractions. It helps me think about when I should multiply, when I should divide. So if my recipe called for 6 cups of flour and my scoop held 2 cups, then it's clear what I do. Then it's clear it's just division. I need 3 scoops, because I need 6 cups total. Each time I scoop, I get 2 cups. That's just 6 divided by 2. I'm going to have to scoop 3 times. This is a division problem. So now, we can come back here and we know what to do. We need 5 1/3 cups total. Each scoop is 2/3 of a cup. So I need to divide by 2/3 to tell how many scoops I need to use to make my 5 1/3 cups. And, oh, how do I divide? Oh, right, we know how to divide with fractions. And we know how to turn this mixed number into a fraction. 5 1/3, well, 5 is 15/3. Add on the 1/3, that makes that 16/3. Divided by 2/3, and we know how to divide fractions. This is 16/3 times the reciprocal of 2/3, which is 3/2. Now we can do our cancellation. The 3's cancel, common factor of 2 cancels, and all we're left with is 8 scoops. And I'm going to go make some cookies. We'll be right back.